Can it be I stayed away too long? Or did I leave your mind when I was gone? But it's not my thing trying to get back. But this time let me tell you where I'm at. You don't have to worry, cause I'm coming back to where I should have always stayed. And now I learned the meaning to your story, and it's enough love for me to stay. Can it be I stayed away too long?
Can it be I stayed away too long?
Did I leave your mind when I was gone? It's not my thing trying to get back. Yeah, this time let me tell you where I'm at. I wanna be where you are. Oh, oh, anywhere you are. Oh, oh, I gotta be where you are. Oh, oh, anywhere you are. Oh, oh, please don't close the door to our future. There's so many things we haven't tried. I will love you better than I used to, and give you all the love I have inside. Oh, can it be I stayed away too long?
Can it be I stayed away too long?
Did I leave your mind when I was gone? But it's not my thing trying to get back. Yeah, this time let me tell you where I'm at. I wanna be where you are. Oh, oh, anywhere you are. Oh, oh, I gotta be where you are. Oh, oh, anywhere you are. Oh, oh, I gotta be, oh, yeah, baby, now. I wanna be, oh.
R&B music to me is like, it's jazz and it's gospel.
Like a soulful type vibe.
It has a lot of like riffs and runs, and it's never boring, which I love about it because some music is just like really dry.
Just like secular, it's not like about God or anything, it's like about like love.
Think about R&B music, we think about the soulfulness, the words, we think about love, think about sex, we think about a lot of artists out there today, such as Jill Scott, Stevie Wonder, Alicia Keys. We also think about culture for African Americans, but I bet y'all want to know some history and when it began.
R&B music was born from the migration of African Americans to the urban areas of Chicago, Detroit, Los Angeles, and other cities. In the late 1940s, R&B was described as a jazz blues with a heavy and insistent beat. R&B was becoming popular because of its themes and beliefs. The lyrics of R&B was about everyday life. We'll be right back. really started to show the R&B. People like Diana Ross, The Supremes, The Temptations, and Smokey Robinson. And also Sam Cooke. He was one of the founders of their style, which combined the elements of gospel music. Later, R&B was applied as a blanket term for more than just soul music. It also included funk, danceable, more rhythmic product of soul and jazz, and disco, a genre of dance music.
I think some of it is very pointless, but I think some of it still has a message and it still gets across to people.
A Grammy-winning I'm an American singer-songwriter and multi-instrumentalist and a child prodigy, who developed into one of the most prominent musical figures of the late 20th century. By the age of 13, he wrote a major hit called Fingertip or Two in 1964. In 1964, Stevie Wonder made his film debut, Must Be Fucked, as himself, credited as Little Stevie Wonder. Later, dropping the little from his name, Stevie Wonder went on to have a number of other hits during the mid-1960s. R&B is a genre of expression. Whether you're feeling happy, angry, or maybe sexy and you just want to dance, R&B was that genre where you let all of your emotions out and feel good afterwards. This is R&B. This is Rhythm and Blues.
Bye-bye.